ever since in one of my videos I mentioned, or perhaps it was in the comments, that I like to smoke a fine cigar now and then, I've had several requests to do a cigar video. So without further ado, let's get started. I have laid out a few cigars to talk about. Hopefully I'll have time. But let's talk about the anatomy of a cigar. I'll demonstrate on this Fonseca Cubano Limited. The opened end of a cigar is called the tuck. Some people call it the foot. And it's the end that you have to light. And the other end is called the head. Some people call it the cap. And it's the end that you must cut, in which you will draw the smoke and the air through. And the band is most often placed near the head. Now most people, I guess, probably already knew that. But let's talk about the tobacco itself. A cigar is composed of three types of tobacco. You've got the filler, which is basically the guts. And then you've got several layers wrapped around the filler, which is called the binder, and it holds the filler together. And then you have the wrapper, which holds everything together. Now the filler. The filler can be from any part of the tobacco plant. The top of the plant usually produces the strongest flavor, and the bottom produces the tobacco with the best burning properties. And to achieve the correct taste and burning qualities, most cigars use fillers from varying parts of the plant and varying sources. Meaning that the tobaccos used in a cigar may not all come from the same place or the same country. And these types of fillers are called blended fillers. Now this conversation is revolve around what we call premium cigars. And when we apply the term premium to a cigar, it means that the cigar is not a machine-made, mass-produced, mass-market type of cigar. Premium cigars will have the following characteristics. Constructed from three parts, the filler, the binder, remember the filler, and the binder, and the wrapper. Let's talk about the fillers. Long filler means that the filler was constructed from full leaves. These leaves are picked and stored and aged intact, and they're handled with great care. Rolling long filler cigars takes great skill to ensure that it burns evenly and smoothly. Short fillers consist of loose clippings of leaves that are left over. from the long filler production, or from leaves that broke anywhere along the crop growing process, or I should say the cultivation process. Short filler cigars are still technically considered to be premium cigars, as long as the cigar is still handmade and is constructed from pure, untreated, unhomogenized tobacco. And the next part of the cigar consists of several layers around the filler. I don't know if you can see them, but there's several layers. This is the filler. And several layers around the filler. It's called the binder. It forms the filler into a circular shape so that the next and final component, the wrapper, can be applied. Let's use some cigar lingo. A puro is a cigar that is made entirely from the tobaccos of one country. An example of probably the best known, most well-known puro is a Cuban cigar. The difficulty in acquiring the necessary native ingredients in producing a puro makes a puro very rare. Now, Cuban cigars are contraband. But I don't have any contraband, see. Another example of a puro would be this cigar made in the Dominican Republic. It's made by Fuente. They call this an Opus X. The basic shapes of a cigar, there's really only two. There's a Pajero, which is a straight-sided cigar, like this Particus. It's just straight. Then you have a Figurado, like this Cubano 59. It's an exotic, irregular. As far as the size of the cigar, well, there's two numbers that are used to classify the size. And the numbers actually tell you the length and the ring gauge, or I should say the diameter of a cigar. The length of a cigar is measured in inches. Sorry, Britain. And the ring gauge is measured in 64ths of an inch. For example, a cigar that is called a 8x48 is 8 inches long by 48 64ths of an inch in diameter. A lot of times a cigar's name will also indicate its dimensions. You've got Robustos that are short and thick. You got a Lonsdale, which is thin and long, kind of like this. You got a Corona, medium length and medium thickness, like this Opus X. You got a Churchill, which is long and thick. I don't have one out right now. And this is a Cigarillo, which is short and thin. And these are only some generic shape names. And I say that because a Robusto from one brand may have slightly different dimensions than a Robusto from another brand. And there's some shapes that fall in between these. There's a Toro, which is somewhere between a Robusto and a Churchill. A Panatello, which is basically a skinny Lonsdale. A Rothschild, there's somewhere between a Robusto and a Corona. And then there's a Presidente, which is can be either larger or smaller than a Churchill. And then there's the color of the wrappers. I don't know, there's about a dozen or so, but they're all variations from the basic ones. And the lightest would be a Candela, which is basically still green. And then getting darker from there would be a Double Claro, a Claro, a Colorado. This Partagas would be an example of a Colorado colored wrapper. And then there's a Colorado Maduro, which this Monte Cristo would be a Colorado Maduro. And there's a Colorado Rosado. And then there's just your basic Maduro, which is what this is. You see the difference between a Colorado and a Maduro. And then there's Oscuro, which is almost black. And this Fuente cigar would be an example of that. A premium cigar, by definition, is handmade. And usually with long filler tobacco. It's 100% pure tobacco leaves throughout its construction. And unlike cigarettes or machine-made cigars, they have no chemicals that are added that will keep them from drying out. And because of this, you must store your premium cigars in the correct humidity. If you want to preserve the moisture content, if you don't, the cigar will dry out and crumble, and you don't want that to happen. If you take a cigar that has been stored properly, you should be able to squeeze it without it cracking. That's because there's moisture. Time to talk about much else. Maybe in the future I'll do a video just on humidors, which are the boxes that you store cigars in at the proper humidity and temperature. But I just, in 15 minutes, I don't have time to talk about how to prepare a cigar to light, or how to light one. So I hope this short video will make the cigar aficionados happy and proud.